is the M1 Mac for you. Depending on your needs and your budget, buying the right computer for you now can save you time, money, and frustration down the road. I'm Rafael, and welcome to the channel where our goal is to always fix it in camera and then finesse it in post. And I always appreciate the early thumbs up because buying a computer at any price point is always an investment. And we all want it to last for as long as possible before we even think about upgrading it. Now, after having the M1 Mac Mini for a few weeks, here are my thoughts on it for anyone that does any moderate creative work like video editing, photo work, and music, and consistently has multiple large apps open at the same time, like Final Cut Pro, Photoshop, DaVinci Resolve, Premiere Pro, Logic, or Audition. With these apps, it's best to always get a computer with at least 16 gigs of RAM, ideally 32 when Apple finally releases the next-gen M1X processors with higher RAM variants. But get as much RAM as your budget can afford. Even if you feel like your workload is light to moderate today, and you feel like the M1 Mac is perfect for you, it may not be 2 to 3 years from now. If any variable changes over the next year, like software or the OS is updated, that will require a little bit more resources, it may really slow down your system. And it'll frustrate you and potentially force you to upgrade early, which in the long run will actually cost you more time and money. Also, just like SSDs and other hard drives that slow down when they get close to full, same thing happens with RAM. Computers tend to slow down as the hard drive fills up. Hard drives need empty space for virtual memory or swap memory. When RAM becomes full, it creates a file on the hard drive for those overflow tasks. If the computer does not have the space available for this, it may slow down drastically. This is why I can't really recommend the base model M1 to anyone that does any moderate creative work with any of the large apps. Time and again, it has been shown that a typical system uses 4 to 5 gigs of RAM just to operate basic functions like web surfing, word processing, and general system tasks. And most large apps use at least 5 gigs of RAM. Photoshop, for instance, recommends at least 8 gigs of RAM as an ideal range. The same goes for Premiere Pro. You can go down to 3 gigs, but with the system already idle with 5 gigs, it's already blown past the 8 gig system resource. Final Cut Pro, 8 gigs is recommended, and for DaVinci Resolve, the minimum system requirements is 16 gigs. So that means that the rest of that has to go somewhere, the SSD and swap memory. And today, most of these apps are being shifted to use GPU more, and the M1 has dedicated graphics that again will be pushed far beyond what they are meant for. Over the past few weeks, I've been keeping an eye on the RAM, and it's consistently and comfortably working in the 9 gigabyte range with the large apps, and 12 to 14 gigabytes with two of these large apps working at the same time, like Final Cut and Photoshop. If the RAM is there, the computer will use it instead of sending it to the cache or swap memory. So the more you have, the snappier your system will always feel. 16 gigs is the minimum I would recommend. Honestly, it should be the default entry on any computer moving forward with 512 gigabytes of SSD. Either way, always choose to up the RAM and the storage to make your computer feel snappier even a year from now. I know that if I spent money on a computer today, I would want it to work as expected for the entire time I had it, not just for the first year or two. I aim to buy computers that will last 3 to 5 years or longer. What I mean by that is that I will buy something that is overpowered today, but will be able to keep up with my workflow for 5 years. Applications over that time frame become more powerful and use more system resources and push the system to its max. It's like trying to play a game today on a 5-year-old system. How well do you think that will work? Cameras and codecs will also be more taxing on computers 3 to 5 years from now. The M1 may be great for you today, but 3 to 5 years from now, it will be underpowered, probably even within 2 years from now. But if you need something today, get the M1 MacBook Pro or the Mac Mini with 16 gigabytes of RAM. The fan will allow for longer stretches of high performance over the no fan MacBook Air, which may throttle the workload to protect the computer. RAM is RAM, and if the computer needs to use a lot of swap memory constantly, that means the way you use a computer needs more RAM to run well. If the computer is using the SSD like RAM, it's dramatically underpowered for what you need. There is a reason that these are entry-level machines. Treat them as such. Save the money now and wait for something that will last for the long run. The only people that I would recommend the base 8-gig M1 Mac or any M1 computer is anyone that does light creative work, but mostly web surfing, word processing, emails, and using it as a dedicated stream computer. And that is because Apple is on the cusp of releasing their new M1X iMacs, MacBook Pros, and Mac Pros. So at this point, I feel most should wait to buy a computer right now. I've made 3 videos about this exactly. The M1 is a computer not designed with power users in mind, but having it has allowed me to test it under a stress environment. And this just solidifies that the M1 Mac does get me really excited for what is coming down the pipe from Apple. Always get more RAM and storage, especially if it's not upgradable after you buy it. the extra headroom will make any computer feel snappy for years. Check out these other videos I have about the M1 Max. As always, thanks for watching. Give this video a big thumbs up. Subscribe. I'm Raphael. I'll talk to you soon. Bye for now.